is the director of the school. She started the school with her father and her brother. Dominica herself was raised in an orphanage here in Santo Domingo that's still running today. She'll show you that orphanage anytime you'd like to see it. She received, as a high school student, she received a Rotarian grant to come to the United States or go to the United States to study. And she said from a very young age, she knew that what she wanted to do was come back, was to get education and come back and provide a safe and nurturing environment for children who would grow up just as she did.
We have children that they come from a very poor, very extremely poor environment. Also children that they are orphans or abandoned.
In 2015, Dominica, the school, and even the students to some extent were visibly stressed, and rightly so. They were in a very, very difficult financial situation and facing potentially closing the school or sending 300 students out of the school who couldn't afford to attend, who couldn't afford food. So I think really the thing that I kind of take heart in is one of the biggest changes that we've brought to the school and our involvement is a comfort level and a stability and a continuity, and that the staff can have, that they have an ability to continue to care for these children, and we provide that by committing to a level of support that in their operating budget every year that allows them to commit to those students, and that certainly addresses the stress level of the organization.
As a substitute teacher in the Upper Arlington School Districts and a former teacher in Cincinnati, I feel like I've seen excellent education in action, and I feel like this is it. I'm really impressed with the cooperative learning that goes on at the Dominica School and Orphanage. There's really a sense of community, and a community development is a vital part of that. All the kids help each other out, they support each other. Oftentimes in American schools, you can see kids being a little bit overly competitive, and it's almost fascinating and a little inspiring to see very little of that, if any at all, in the Dominica School and Orphanage. Each of the kids really helps, supports, lifts each other up, and it really feels like they're a family, like they're a community, and I think that's part of the educational program.
The one student that I really was so impressed with her story, her name was Francesca, and she's a ninth grader. Dominica took us up to, first of all, visit the house. I put house in quotes, the house where she was born. It's just a small tin shanty. And she was born there and lived there for 2 years. And then her home situation became so dismal that she and her siblings moved into the school and orphanage, and she lived there for several years. She was finally reunited with her grandmother and moved into her grandmother's home. And Dominica drove us to that home again. Again, that's another plywood and sheet metal shanty. And the grandmother had us in and served us coffee. And it was just a real meaningful experience for me because I just was so impressed with the level of the poverty. It was just hard to imagine that this young woman who is so attractive, great posture, wants to learn, can speak English very well, that she is actually living in this level of poverty. And it really convinced me of the great work that Dominica is doing, the fact that she can provide this kind of experience for a young woman living in this environment.
The investment in the high school student classrooms is really kind of personal for me. Over the past 3 years, I became really close with one of the female students. Her name is Bridget, and she was in my math class for 3 years in a row, and I became very close with her. I thought she was a star math student, and she was really interested and engaged. And on the last visit, I hugged her and said, well, I'll see you next year. And she started to cry and said, you know, well, I won't because I'm going into high school. And, you know, we don't have a high school here anymore. And it really hit me that, you know, I'd heard from Dominica the concern, especially for young women, that they were sending them to the public schools, or a lot of students were not even continuing their education because there was no high school available and there was no social program, which we support financially, to keep those students in school. And so for me, kind of the emotions of not being able to address Bridget and keeping her at the school, at least through the addition of the two classrooms that we're adding there this year, we'll be able to address the next wave of students and hopefully, you know, potentially get Bridget back at the school as well within 12 to 24 months.
Thanks to them, we are keeping hundreds of children in this program. They were ready to go. We were ready to let them go, to send them back to their places where they won't be having food or a school or caring. This past school year and this year, they are able to be in our environment.